In this video, I will show you how to use the advanced search tool. We'll go through the different options you have to tailor your search and look at the search results in the search view. We'll also perform a semantic query using ESCG. Before we start with the advanced search, let me give you just a quick summary of the search tools that we explored so far. There's the quick search, which is up here. And it's a global search, so if I type in a term, for instance cardio, it will search different terminologies like SNOMED CT, ICD-10, ATC, but also other resources. For instance, there's a reference set here that has cardio in it, and it will also show me the previous choices and the bookmarks. The other search tool is the filter search, and each concept navigator has its own filter search, so the search is limited to the concept that you pick. So if I type in the same term here, it will display the results within the hierarchy, so it has the advantage that you can see where in the hierarchy your concept is located, so if it's more specific further down or more of a general concept. Both the quick search and the filter search will show the preferred term. However, the search results also consider synonyms, so this is why you have some results that don't have cardio in it, but if I open this concept, you will see that one of the synonyms here is cardiospasm, so this is why it picked this result as well. Okay, so much about the quick search and the filter search. Now let's go to the advanced search. You can invoke it by simply pressing this button here, the flashlight button in the main toolbar, and it will open the search dialog. You see there are different tabs here. This is because you can restrict your search to different kind of resources. So you can look for SNOMED CT concepts, you can look for concepts in different terminologies, you can look for descriptions, so it will bring back all the synonyms and the fully specified names. You can do a search for reference sets, which we will talk about in a later video, and whatever you pick, the user interface will always change so that it makes sense for the resource. You can also look for tasks or for files. So it's the most comprehensive search tool. But we will focus today on the SNOMED CT concept search, so we'll work with this tab here. If I do a search here, there's the index search and there's the ESCG query search, which we'll talk about later. But let's start with the index search. You can have your search based on the concept ID, the preferred term, the fully specified name, synonym, or other descriptions. So it depends whatever you click, it will bring back the results and you can have any combination you want to have. You can also restrict the status to active or inactive. The quick search and the filter search will only bring back active concepts, while this search tool, you can search for inactive concepts as well. And you can restrict it, and that's something you can't do with the other two search tools either, to the top level concept. So let's look for clinical findings, for active clinical findings. And let's type in a term, diabetes, and simply just hit search. Okay, and then you see your search results are always displayed in the search view. So whenever you do a search with this tool, your results will be displayed here. And let me maximize this. So these are all the clinical findings that have the term diabetes. And you can see there is a score. There's sorted based on the similarity score, which considers your search profile and the concept usage frequency, the concept ID, the preferred term, the fully specified name, and you can see that it's active because we're just looking for active concepts. You can sort your results simply by clicking the column, and it sorts them alphabetically or the other way around, and that works with all of the columns. So you can also sort the score or the concept ID. And you can also filter your results. If I type in diabetic, then I just get the terms back that have diabetic. If you cancel it, then it will display all of the results again. A nice feature in this search view is this little pin button. This will keep this search, this will keep the tab. So if I click it and I pin the search, then it will stay here. So if I perform a new search, which I will do now, let's look for inactive diabetes concepts, and I have to choose this one. So there's no top-level concepts because they are not linked to the terminology anymore. So I have no top-level category here in my search dialog. And let's do the search here. And you see now it opened a new tab, and all of the search results are now inactive. So this is my first search, and that's my second. And you can also see the searches here in a search history. So if you would like to perform a search again, you just click this one, and then it will override the active window with this search. If you don't want to override it, you click this button, and that's your search history again, and then you have open in new, so it would open the search that you pick in a new tab here, or you can override it by simply hitting open, or you can remove different searches as well, so you can always go back to the searches that you performed and then click back and forth. Okay, let's pin this one again to keep it. And let's look at this diabetes search that I did before with 259 results. And let's do this search in the quick search. And you see it has 299 results, so there are more results. If I click Control 4, it will display more. And the reason is because it also contains the procedures and the situations with explicit context, so not only the clinical findings. So this one was restricted to the clinical findings, and this one has all concepts that have the term diabetes in it. So this search, you can restrict your search, and here you always have all of the results. That's the difference. And depending on what you want, you pick a search tool. Okay, you can also use wildcards and Boolean operators to refine your search. I'll show you how this works. What you probably know is the star. This is the most useful one. It substitutes any number of characters. For instance, if I type in dia and do a star, then it will, and let's just look for active clinical findings. Then it will show me all results that start with dia. Okay, if we look at them, there you have 862, so they're quite a lot. So you do not only have diabetes, but you have also diarrhea or diagnosis, so everything that starts with dia. And if you, let's pin this as well. See, now we have already three tabs. If you just type in the star without anything, it will give you all of the results back. So if you're just looking for all the clinical findings, all the active or inactive clinical findings, or all the fully specified names, then you just put in the star. And now, of course, it takes a little bit longer because it's a much bigger search. And it should give us all the active clinical findings back. And we have over 98,000, but it's still pretty fast. Okay, Boolean operators. Let's close this one. So you just close it like this. If we look in our search history now, we have already four different searches that we've performed, and you can clear the history just like you can do in your internet browser. It works pretty much the same. Okay, you won't need AND because the AND is implied. So if I type in diabetes and mellitus, it's like typing in diabetes and mellitus, so it will bring back results that match both diabetes and mellitus. And let's do this. Okay, and here we have diabetes, mellitus, 179 search results, and you see here it's always diabetes and mellitus that's in it. And of course you can filter them as well again. Let's pin it. If I want to look for terms that contain either diabetes or mellitus, I use OR. And now I have more results. You see diabetes or mellitus, 246. Search history. There you can see what you were looking for. So it's quite nice. You can see diabetes or mellitus. That was just the star. You can see the number of results. You can even see the execution time. And these are my different searches. Okay. Another one is the NOT. That's quite useful. So I can do diabetes, but not mellitus. So I want to exclude mellitus. And that should bring back a lot less. And that's why it's very quick. It's only 67 results, and there should be no mellitus in it. So it's all only diabetes. Okay. So much about the index search. What I wanted to show you, but I don't want to go into too much detail, is the is when you do a search for concepts based on their semantic meaning. And for this, you will need the extended SNOMED CT compositional grammar, which is ESCG, and it looks like this. If you're already familiar with this, you can type in your own terms. So usually when you open it, I already pasted something in here, but usually when you open it, you have an empty window. And if you hit Control Space, then it will give you different terms. So here in this case, it only gives me the operators that are possible now. But if it's an empty window, then you can pick different concepts and the different symbols that you need. Or of course, you can type it in as well. But you will have to pick a concept because you probably won't know the concept ID. So the query I wanted to show you is a query that is looking for clinical findings things that have a finding site in the cardiac valve structure, and we want to exclude veterinarian terms. This is why we prohibit it. That's a sign for prohibiting the non-human simple ref sets. That's a sign here for ref sets. So we're looking for non-veterinarian clinical findings related to the cardiac valve structure. So that's already a pretty complicated query we're doing here. And let's do it. Okay. It returned 629 results. And so here are all of my findings. So you can exclude reference set. It's quite neat once you know how this works. You can do pretty specific searches with it. I will do an own session about these kind of searches, and then I'll explain a little bit more about what the different expressions mean. If you're curious, we included in our Project Explorer already some files related to these kind of queries. There's a little tutorial which is called Getting Started with Semantic Queries, and it starts with very easy ones. So it's just looking for concepts and then clinical findings, and then it gets a little bit more complicated. So you can go through the different examples and run these searches, and so you gradually learn how it works. And we have also some semantic queries already in there, for instance here in this folder clinical findings, and if you click on one of them, this is actually then the query, and you can actually run it just by simply pressing this green button, so you don't have to copy and paste it in your window here. Okay, but we'll save this for a later session. That's all I wanted to show you about the advanced search.